Now, there are only two residential facilities for teens who have committed crimes in Southwest Florida, but that number is about to be cut in half. As NBC2's Risa Moore shows us, the Department of Juvenile Justice says it's not renewing its contract with AMI Kids Big Cypress.
We say we change the lives of troubled youth.
AMI Kids Big Cypress is deserted. For the last 20 years, the Department of Juvenile Justice funded the program for young men court ordered to the facility. The DJJ decided not to renew the facility's contract, and when I asked why, they would only tell me they chose not to accept the bid. In 2 weeks, facility director Marvin Farrell will shut these gates forever.
It's definitely a blow. It's a decision that we definitely didn't want to see.
As for the kids who are receiving treatment here, some are headed home because they've completed the program, while others are being sent to other Department of Juvenile Justice facilities.
Family support is a big part of services that we provide, so we wanted to try to work with the Department of Juvenile Justice to get them closer to home.
Attorney Shannon McPhee says this facility closing is indicative of a trend across the country.
And as you see more and more counseling programs shutting down and funding becoming more of a challenge, kids without the resources are not getting the help that they need.
In the past 20 years, 800 kids have come through the AMI Kids Big Cypress program. Farrell says they have a 70% success rate.
Our track record, so to speak, is very good, and it's very disheartening to see the doors close when we've had a lot of success here working with this population.
AMI Kids Big Cypress will shut down on July 30th. Risa Morris, NBC2.
Now, there is only one other residential facility in Southwest Florida, and that's in Fort Myers. Kids who would have been sent to Big Cypress before will now be sent to other centers across the state.